Hey everyone, this is YML, and in today's video, we are going to dive into the world of clustering algorithms and explore a powerful model known as Gaussian Mixture Models, or GMMs in short. Also, before moving on, I highly recommend you to watch my video where I explain the multivariate normal distribution if you haven't already. I guarantee you that if you do that, this video will be much easier to understand. Alright, so let's get started. Before we delve into the details of GMMs, let's compare them to k-means clustering, which many of you might be familiar with. Both are clustering algorithms, but one important distinction is that k-means assigns each data point to the cluster of its nearest neighbors, whereas GMMs introduce a probabilistic approach by modeling data points as a mixture of multiple Gaussian distributions. So in simple terms, k-means puts a hard clustering label on each data point, whereas GMMs assigns a softer clustering label, telling us how probably it's for a data point to belong to a certain cluster. But how does the Gaussian mixture model achieve that? Well, imagine that you have the following data and you want to create a distribution you want to use to sample new data. Although not perfect, a good initial guess would be to say that this data comes from a Gaussian distribution and try to fit such a model on top of it by using something like the maximum likelihood estimation. However, what do you do if your data looks like this? Simply fitting a Gaussian distribution would not yield good results since this data is grouped into several clusters. So in order to have a much more representative distribution for it, you need to fit a Gaussian on top of each cluster, which is basically what GMM tries to achieve. The mathematics behind this is quite simple, yet elegant, and the algorithm relies on the expectation maximization algorithm to find the best possible fit for our Gaussians. In short, the expectation maximization, or EM algorithm, is a quite powerful iterative optimization method that's supposed to estimate parameters in statistical models when there is missing or incomplete data, such as the parameters of our Gaussians in the GMM model. And it consists of iteratively applying two steps. The expectation step, where the algorithm calculates the expected value of the log likelihood function given the current parameter estimates, and the maximization step, where the algorithm updates the parameter estimates to maximize the expected log likelihood calculated in the E step. So, in other words, what happens is that we are bootstrapping from our initial guess by alternating between the E step and the M step, allowing us to refine our parameter estimates. For the GMM model, this translates to firstly having an initial guess of where each Gaussian should be centered, how their covariance matrix should look like, and how much weight we should provide to each Gaussian in the final distribution. All these are the latent or hidden variables of our model that we don't know and that we are trying to estimate. And now, let's look at the mathematics of Gaussian mixture models. Simply put, the probability of sample X is equal to the weighted sum of probability that the sample has in each Gaussian. When fitting this model, in the expectation step, we compute gamma hat ik, which is the probability that the ith sample was generated by the kth Gaussian, by dividing the weighted probability of that sample to be produced by the kth Gaussian with the weighted sum over the probabilities that the ith sample was generated by each jth Gaussian. Then, in the maximization step, we recompute our parameter estimates of the Gaussian mixture model. Firstly, the new weight of each kth Gaussian is computed by averaging the probabilities of all points belonging to that cluster. Secondly, the mean of each Gaussian, mu hat k, is calculated as the weighted sum by gamma ik of all points. Finally, we calculate the new variance in the same way as the weighted variance by gamma ik between each data point and the newly estimated mu hat k. And that's basically how the GMM model works. I hope you found this explanation helpful. Please hit the thumbs up button if you did, and subscribe to be up to date with the new content. See you next time. Bye bye.